Now we will see the athletes enter the arena.
Hier sind sie und hier ist euer Applaus. Bitte begrüßt.
So the very first thrower will be Wojciech Nowicki of Poland. What a record he's building up. Third in this event in 2016, Olympic and world medals.
The European leader with 81 meters 85 representing Poland. For Poland, Wojciech Nowicki.
The hammer throws keep going on and on, it seems. I mean, not that all of them are that old, but you've got the first five from 2016 all coming back, competing here today.
European Championships for Norway.
Former European junior in fourth place, all the way back in 2009. That's Erling Henriksen. But he's improved this year to a national record in 76-66. He's the second throw. Then we have Sergei Magiev from Moldova, eighth. Back to 2016 from the European Junior Series. Two sisters, of course, top hammer throwers. We have the Russian authorized neutral athlete, Denis Lukyanov. Not such a major record that he competed in European Juniors 11 years ago. And then Pavel Barysha of Belarus, again one of the contenders for a medal of his consistent form in the high 70s this season. And here's a man who's been collecting age group titles, Benji Halas of Hungary, world junior champion, European junior champion, European under 23 champion. Three gold medals to his credit in the age groups. Now, none to be underestimated is this man, Mihail Anastasakis. He looked good in qualifying, and he in fact was fourth in these championships when they're in Amsterdam. The youngest competitor now, Ivan Tikhon, the defending champion, Pavel Freidek, also the silver medalist back in 2014, three times world champion as well. Pavel Freidek, who's been the world number one for a number of years now. Marcel Domnicki of Slovakia, fifth last time, seventh in 2014, fifth also in the Olympics, a consistent competitor at world-class level. His best just below 80 metres.
And
the third man in this field who's thrown over 80 this year is Nick Miller, who excelled in the first day of the Commonwealth Games to smash the British record with 80 metres 26 and take Commonwealth gold. He's also a former European under 23 champion, which he did 3 years ago. There's Team Miller, ready to urge him on. So those are the 12 men who qualified, 73 metres plus in the qualifying round yesterday. And they'll get underway very shortly.
And Peter has already mentioned that battle we're expecting between the two Polish athletes there. Very different size, different styles we're seeing amongst them.
Well, indeed, as I say, the clash between the Poles will be opened by Wojciech Nowicki. Nowicki, who heads the world list this year, 81 metres 85, which he did in Czechoslovakia in Hungary, the beginning of July, to open the European Championships hammer final of 2018. Tapes out in the arena at 70 and 80 metres. Solid across the circle, and that's a good start. It must be around 76, 77 area. Hoping to exceed that. He's exceeded it many times this year, but it's a very useful start to get a good throw in the competition. Like many throwers, they may well improve as the competition goes on, as they get used to the surface of the circle. Sometimes they prefer it more slippery than they're certainly going to get today. Nowicki's opening effort, showing the scoreboard at 77 metres 90. Already that's the sort of distance which might well get a medal. Elvin Henriksen next into the circle. Now his Norwegian record, 76-66. And again, a very good throw, because that can't be far off that record performance. So an excellent start to the competition by the Norwegian. Norway again have had quite a few useful hammer throws over the years. And way back in half a century, his first Anglia set a world record in the hammer. And Henriksen, 76.05. Superstar. 61 centimetres short of his national record. Sergei Magiev, the Moldovan. His personal best is 78.72. A couple of metres short of that, his best this year. And there's his opener. 72-ish. Magiev has made a number of world finals, but eighth year and then eighth in the world as well. His best at senior level. Quite been able to reproduce his very best form when it comes to these big events. So, 72-72. And it's Lukianov next. Best, just short of 80, 79-61. I can tell you that the high jump bars now at 196 and 187 respectively, so still very early days. Piano improved this year as a neutral athlete to compete internationally. And that was just a month ago that he came through. The cage there, so a no throw for Show for Belarus next, twice a World University Games champion. Narrow in there in the hammer cage. Gradually over the years, safety considerations have meant that the sector has been narrowed. When all weather tracks first came in, to see hammers bouncing on the opponent and crowd once or twice. Another one into the right hand side of the cage, so a second successive no throw there.
There aren't many hammer throwers who spin the other way around, are there?
No, indeed, left-handers are a fairly sparse quantity, rather less than one would think actually in the population as a whole.
Going back to the decathlon, Arthur Avila might be left-handed, might actually be one of those who throw discus with his left hand. That's one to look out for tomorrow. Mm-hmm.
Now into the hammer circle comes one of the top competitors, Wojciech Nowicki, who's ranked fourth in Europe this year with 79.57 meters. Youngster, had his 21st birthday just a few days ago. Yeah, that's a good one. That's going to challenge that lead that was set at 77.19 by Nowicki. Coach's pleased with that. 77.15, so it's just 4 centimeters down when Nowicki's opening. Now, this is Mihail Anastasakis. Don't underestimate the Greek athlete here. He excelled with fourth place 2 years ago in Amsterdam. Of age. That's here after a useful competitive season, second in the World Championships, but hasn't been competing in the Hammer Challenge events. A little further, 73.33. It's the fourth best so far after 7 players. Very fast, balancing just a little. Good throw though. This is personal best is 75.50. European junior champion last year, and the year before that was the Youth Olympic Games champion. Once this year, all the experience in the world.
There, as we look at it, we were just briefly talking about it earlier, but in the hammer throw, there was a study that was released last year after the World Championships in London talking about the optimal release angle, and it has shown that 45 degrees is the best angle you can have. And I think the man who is about to step in the ring here, Pavel Fajdek, is one of those who comes closest to those 45 degrees. I think his release angle was about 46 degrees. So he really, when he gets it right, when he gets that angle right, has that optimum release angle, and it shows given his overall status in this event.
The challenge, Michelle, to determine the direct angle right now. Pavel Fajdek with his first try. Oh, he's got all the speed, hasn't he? And that's a fine opener by Fajdek. Yes, that's taken the lead in this first round of the hammer. Just about a metre short of the 80 metre line. At the moment, the honour's going to Fajdek, with Nowicki in second place, Alas just behind. Superb technique. His arms straight forward. And he goes. A couple of dips on his career record, but really a sensationally good one. And there it is, 78.69. is the lead in the first round of the hammer. Fajdic.
Whoa.
2 throws to go in this first round. Nitching it. And then Nick Miller, who's started the season, goes to South Sydney, Cromwell comes back in April. 80 metres, 26, he's competing extensively on the IAF Hammer Challenge series of competitions. But he's a bit more stuck on the 75-ish metre level at the moment, so let's see if he can get back close to that British record. First round of the hammer, Fajdic leading at 78-69 from Nowicki, 77-19, and Halash 77-50. Could be Nowicki to open round two. Start of this year, when the great Polish athletes met, Fajdic won, I think, the first three competitions, but then Nowicki had a series of wins. Just has the upper hand in the second part of the season. Certainly heads the European rankings at 81-85 from Fajdic's 81-40. Circle well, and that hammer's flying out there, and he's urging it on and pretty much landing on the 80 meter tape. So that will take the lead for the Polish athlete, Nowicki. coach looks on and can obviously approve of what he's done now. It was anticipated to be a great contest between these two British stars. It's blown into that very nicely indeed. And this hitting that tape and the measurement coming through, it is indeed exactly 80 metres there, with a great roar on the face of Wojciech Nowicki, and the Polish contingent are absolutely thrilled. There it is, 80 metres after his opening 77.19. Ride it, Banchan. Oh, get away from that. So that's a disappointment. It's better about getting the measurement. So two rounds end with the poles. Nowicki in first, Ride in second, Alice in third. And he said in this round, Henriksen has improved his Norwegian record to 76-71 in fourth place. In second place, 78-69, then Alex 77-68, and Henriksen, Wojciech Nowicki, previously announced. So here's Nowicki then, in the first throw of this third round. Nowicki exactly 80 metres. European leader this year. Did it again, it's another fine throw. And yes, it's over 80 this time. So a little bit of improvement. What brilliant form he is throwing, showing, as he has indeed for several months now. So he's establishing an ascendancy over his rival. Which keeps every round so far. They like it, no question about that. Nowicki's throw, 80 metres 12 here.
Then,
so far. He's best before that throw at least, 75-20. In fifth place, Tikhon in sixth, 75-12. Improvement. I need to check on that. As I said, 77-36 is distance level. This one comes down at 77.36. A moment or two ago, so he improves his position. Now the hammer. Back we come to Berecho in the final round, building towards the climax now.
The
speed really got behind that. Let's see what the distance is. The ratio. It's a couple of meters if he's going to move into a medal slot, so he's going to even that. It's far off. It's around 77. So let's just check out for the distance. 77.02. So it takes him up to 4. Well, that's always a tantalizing position, but Halash remains ahead with 77.36 and also another 77.15. Now, Tikhon, who set a season's best in the previous round, 75.70. The 42-year-old oldest man in the field. Plenty of championships to his credit, and also a draft disqualification. over 75 metres just before this. Just short, 75-23. So a good series for the veteran. But he's going to end up in sixth place. Well, we come to the top men at the start of this round. Horatio has moved ahead of Henriksen now, the Norwegian in fifth place off that national record of 76-86. Henriksen's been around quite a long while, but having his best ever season. Fine competition though, not to complain at a national record. Fifth place, 76-86. So after that throw, we know the medalists, the top three, have yet to take their final throws to see if there can be any change in the order. Here's Palash. 77-15 and 77-36 solidifies him in bronze place, in some way down on the great poles. Well, a fine competition for Halash, again around 77, and he takes his first senior medal, having already won World Junior and European Under 23 golds in the last few years. So, outstanding young talent here. Producing a good series also as well, so no well done. He's got the bronze medal. Now, the last chance for the treble world champion, reigning champion, silver medalist in 2014, Pavel Fajdek of Poland, to see if he can eclipse this man, Wojciech Nowicki. Going to be enough, is it? No. Standing well short. But silver medal to add to the credentials of a great thrower. Pavel Fajdek will take the silver medal in the hammer competition at the European Championships Berlin 2018. With his opening throw of 78 metres 69. Congratulations there between him and Nowicki.
And we can see there is a large Polish contingent in the crowd, not just from the team, but there are Polish flags everywhere. But then again, it's not actually that far to drive over. So they have made the way over to really support their athletes because they've got a few more medal contenders as the week goes on.
This was the event that, of course, they were looking forward to, an expected one too. Doesn't always work out like that, but it has here, as this man, Wojciech Nowicki of Poland, is sure of the gold medal. Can he yet again improve his distance well beyond the 80-metre line? 80-12 in round three, this is lead. No, I don't think so. He looked a little lackluster there. But what a fine demonstration the Polish athletes have given. Once before, a Polish athlete won gold in the European Championships. Kajut's route back in 1958 in Stockholm. But now they've run better with a 1-2 headed by Nowicki, who's come this season from behind his compatriot Fajdek. Last throw there of 78-81. So it meant that he had, in fact, the best four throws of the competition.
I was just about to say, have you seen his series there? I mean, that is some consistency. His shortest one was 77 metres, so it just shows his dominance at the moment.
Well, I was reading an interview with Nowicki in the last autumn, where he talked about the fact that he hoped the turning point was when he won last year's national championship. He didn't beat Fajdek in any other event last year. Fajdek had a very long winning streak going back to 2016. But he said, I've had enough now being number two and number three. I know that I can be Fajdek. They're very good friends, but they do have different coaches. They group together often on Polish international tracks. He goes, this winter I'm going to work so hard to try and start beating him on a more regular basis. And just look, so it's proved.